Has created so many historical moments throughout his decorated career. A victory tonight would be another prestigious accolade for the multi-time world champion and Olympic gold medalist.
Guys, you have to have a screw loose or something to step into the ring with the odds this firmly against you.
Kurt Angle has earned medals, championships, and a Hall of Fame ring. The Olympic hero does not play second fiddle to anyone in that locker room.
Byron, are you kissing up to get points from the general manager? Anyway, you forgot to mention that he won an Olympic gold medal with a broken freaking neck.
I was going to mention it.
I always loved a good handicap match growing up, especially when you'd see Andre the Giant go up against two or three jabronis. Despite being outmanned, you always knew Andre would walk away with the win.
Andre the Giant really was the king of the handicap matches, Corey was saying earlier. He also made quite a name for himself competing in battle royals, as you would suspect, seeing as he's well over 500 pounds.
I think my favorite Andre the Giant battle royal moment came at WrestleMania 2, when he last eliminated both members of the Hart Foundation to walk away with the win. No getting him over that top rope that night, fellas.
An impressive series of moves right there. Absolutely flattened him.
We've seen some pretty lopsided handicap matches over the years. One that stands out in my mind, well, it might just be the 2010 encounter that saw John Cena take on six members of the Nexus. Oh, yeah, here's Akam.
His shoulders are down. DDT for a kick out. Clearly not enough damage done. That 6-on-1 match Byron brought up earlier actually could have even been more lopsided. If you remember, it was originally supposed to be 7-on-1, but John Cena was able to take Darren Young out of the equation when he injured him the week prior.
Well, you know what? He should have kept taking Nexus members out. Because even without Darren Young, Nexus was able to accomplish their goal that way, defeat John Cena.
He goes for the cover. That was nowhere near a 3 count.
Hey, I guess you never know. A lot can go wrong in a match like this, guys. In fact, I'll be surprised if we don't see a major injury occur here tonight.
Wow, he got out of it.
Yeah, I'm not so sure he had a clue what he was doing.
Dangerous atmosphere, and being outmanned in any way, whether it's by one, two, or even more competitors, can result in serious.
He fights his way free, but how much energy did he exhaust fighting his way out?
Impact and in some.
Whoa, Angle dodged that one.
He still got it. What incredible impact. When this guy's on, look out. Angle's looking to end it.
He's starting to stagger a bit.
He may have to start reevaluating his game plan.
The important thing is that he doesn't overreact here. He's taken on a
lead. Angle hits it.
On the mark.
But he's got to capitalize now. Angle's looking to end it.
I couldn't hear
that. Break his ankle.
The damage has been done.
Can Razor stay in this after that?
He's on the defensive now. This is not at all where he wants to be at this point in this handicap match.
It's going to be hard for him to win this handicap match if he doesn't somehow find a way to fend off some of this punishment he's taking.
At this point, they both look to be about evenly matched. They may have given him an edge, but not by much.
We may very well be seeing the finisher here very shortly, guys. And when that happens, you can bet this one's going to be over.
Going for the cover. He's a long way from the 3 count, I can tell you that.
It's going to take more than that.
I'm with Corey. I suspect the finisher is on the horizon. And given how impactful that move has been as of late, I'd say there's almost no coming back from it.
Right, Michael. It seems like that finisher has become more and more impactful with each passing week. But that's even possible.
Penny predicament. Gets the shoulder up. Too soon.
Oh, Angle dodged that one.
He still got it.
Guys, remember when Shane McMahon competed against the supposed Legion of Doom in a handicap match back in 1999? What a joke that was. He told everybody he'd go up against Hawk and Animal. Instead, what we got were a couple of LED imposters.
Going to the top. High risk. He's got the shoulders down. Gets the shoulder up before three.
He is not going to go down without a fight, Michael.
I remember the Shane McMahon's handicap match you were mentioning earlier very well, Byron, and those imposters posing as Hawk and Animal in the Legion of Doom were none other than Pat Patterson and Gerald Briscoe. Or should I call them the Stooges?
No, you shouldn't call them the Stooges. Have a little respect, Cole. We're talking about two Hall of Famers here.
Competing in battle royals, as you would suspect, seeing as he's well over 500 pounds.
I think my favorite.
Look out, he breaks free.
Great job by him there, but he's still in a tough spot.
Oh, man, what a hit.
Dropped right off the apron.
Wow, talk about knowing where you're at all times. Wow, man,
what impact. It's safe to say he had his opponent well scouted there.
Brilliant, and there are certain superstars who are synonymous with handicap matches. Of course, there's Andre the Giant, and more recently, Braun Strowman. But I don't think I've ever seen anybody in more handicap matches than Big Show, guys.
He's going for the pin.
Pin broke up easily. Way too early.
I couldn't agree with you more about what you were saying earlier, Michael. It seems like Big Show has been in dozens, if not hundreds, of handicap matches. Believe it or not, I'd say he won the majority of them.
Yeah, but I can tell you one he didn't win. How about on SmackDown back in July of 2008?
He was forced to take it.
Here's Akam! Thunderous Russian leg sweep by Akam.
But he's winning on feud.
He's got him covered. Oh, somehow!
How did he do that?
This incredible beatdown.
Oh man, what a hit.
Rock right off the apron.
Back now inside the ring. Oh, close to getting a count out here.
Nah, this is just some strategic gamesmanship.
More of these superstars can take, guys. You'd have to think something's got to give here soon. This is his opportunity to win this thing.
Here's a cover!
Could be it.
Two! Three!
There's the pinfall. And the victory.
Here are your winners, Akam and Rhaegar, the Hawkers of Fame.
Talk about having to dig down deep the win.
I think we're all glad this match came to a close without any of these guys having to go to a local medical facility. It looked like that might have been the case here for a while.
Look at this talent.